Alrighty, time for round three. Fight. I will keep. Turn two adept. With Harbinger, two above average lands, like Mutavault and Cavern are both solid lands with abilities. And a Spreading Seas. So the fact that I get to draw two cards off this hand makes it a lot more exciting than it would be otherwise. Alright, opponent starting on Polluted Delta into Basic Island, into Serum Visions, of course. Where do the people get all these foil Serum Visions? How lucky are they? Wish I had foil Serum Visions. And my opponent chose to keep both on the bottom. I drew a Cavern of Souls, which is kind of unfortunate. Actually, I think I lead with the Mutavault because my turn two play is most likely going to be Cavern Silver Galadept. Hopefully, my opponent keeps mana up to counter something. Another Cavern of Souls. Alright, well. I don't want to name Mercenary. I'll name Merfolk, though. The second Cavern of Souls is definitely worse than the first. The third is horrendous. That's alright. Well, Cavern of Souls are going to be bad against me this game. I have so many Aether Vials and Caverns. Fortunately, I don't have any creatures. I'm playing against Grixis again, it looks like. Alright. That is pretty nice, so. Let's go land. Do I want to play Aether Vial and attack with Mutavault? I guess I'm going to play Aether Vial first to try to bait out a counterspell. Because if you've got a counterspell, you kind of have to use it. Alright, and then I get to Spreading Seas, the Blood Crypt. And smash. And then now, next turn, I can play Cavern of Souls naming Spirit and play Akira the Great Glass Spinner, which Grixis has a lot of problems with, and I've done a pretty good job of drawing my game one, my one Kira in game one against Grixis. Let's say Spirit. I can't see what that is, let's see. Just to make sure, okay, it's nothing else. Is there something sweet I can name it? Alright, let's name Spirit. Let's play Aether Vial. Because it doesn't matter too much. Opponent can cast Snapcaster for mana. I wonder if I actually fixed my opponent's mana there with with the Spreading Seas. But hey, there's no way to know. Uncounterable. Actually, do not. Well, if this resolves, maybe I attack. Because then, if my opponent wants to trade Snapcaster straight up for Silver Gill Adept, I am fine with that. All right. I'm actually okay with getting the Vial destroyed there, since my creatures are all uncounterable anyway. I could have attacked first. Problem with attacking first is my opponent goes Snapcaster Remand. Desolate Lighthouse. Alright. Need to stop drawing manas. Let's play an uncounterable Merfolk. And then I'm going to play Minamo, School at Water's Edge, and animate Mutavault and attack my opponent for 5 points of damage. And see how this goes. Opponent can Snapcaster Kolaghan's Command, but can't block any of my creatures, and can't kill any of my creatures because of Kira. It has to have, well, they could have, like, I guess Bolt plus a Black Spell, because they don't have double red, and you need double red to really double target. Yeah, this card's very strong. Alright, ascend. See what my opponent does here. I still like that Spreading Seas is actually good for my opponent. Though it does shut off double red, so maybe that's not entirely true. Alright, opponent takes 5. Right past the turn. So my opponent's looting with Lighthouse, I'm pretty happy about that. Discard Steam Vents. My opponent would have had probably decent mana regardless. Pass the turn. Let's see. Play a Curse Catcher. You never know what'll mess your opponent up here. And play an island. And animate Mutavault. So the question now is, what do I attack with? My opponent can, again, Snapcaster, Colgan's Command, and still pay for Curse Catcher. And given that, I do not think there's any reason to attack with Lord of Atlantis into a Snapcaster Mage. I don't really want to dismember a Snapcaster Mage. So, let's just stay home. I can also untap Kira with Minamo. Eh, powerful. And I'm not playing the Harbinger yet. I could have maybe played it this turn if I wanted to play another island and play Cavern Harbinger. Maybe that would have been better. Alright. Here comes the Snappy. I can discard this Cavern of Souls. Yeah, Colgan's Command does not do a whole lot. I guess if you have a Bolt also, but I get to counter the Bolt with Curse Catcher, so maybe you wanted to respond there. I guess my opponent's hoping I'd attack with Lord of Atlantis, but not today. Go fish. Alright, Bolt targeting Lord of Atlantis. Okay. I don't think that's the order you want to do things in. Because now you're going to get your Colgan's Command countered instead of your Lightning Bolt countered. That is just worse for you. Alright. But I'll take it. Because mostly because this works out really well for me. That's why I'll take it. The funny thing is that's on the board too, so yeah, that doesn't feel great. Right, you can't block, and now I'm actually going to play this. Since there's no reason not to play another 3-3. Opponent needs to double target to kill things. And I win the game. Alright, so once again, let's take out these Spreading Seas. Take out two Regeries. Put in Kira. Put in Relics. Put in Spell Pierces. Put in Romance. Alright, so I actually did want all the Spell Pierces this time, I believe. So maybe I just take out all the Regeries and then just don't. Or actually, I could take out a combination of Regeries and Harbingers, maybe. Harbinger seems like it could be good value. I like Vapor Snag against the expensive cards. Yeah, I'd rather have a mix of Harbingers and Regeries. Alright, this hand's pretty marginal. I think I keep it. If I draw any Merfolk, it's pretty good, because I can play turn 1 Curse Catcher and a turn 2 Adept. Let's see. Alright, I drew a Merfolk. Hooray. So now I can play a Curse Catcher. And if my opponent has Remand up, I get to Curse Catcher it. Opponent. I can't Curse Catcher Spell Snare, unfortunately. Let us attack first, in case I need to do this. And I'm going to play Adept. What do I reveal? I'll probably reveal another Adept here. Ah, they have the Spell Snare. I don't really want to show my opponent Master of Waves, because this is a pretty powerful card. Probably going to have to show it to them next turn anyway, but I think that, maybe because I have good odds of casting Adept revealing Master again. I could have just shown the Master, but I think this will be fine here. Ooh, Cavern of Souls. That's actually very good. Let's name Merfolk. Boom. If I'd drawn that last turn, it would have been insane, but this is still pretty good. Can cycle a Remand if they want. Spell? Ooh, Spell Pierce. I didn't finish the statement. Hit with the Curse Catcher. Is it Staticaster? That's going to be hard to beat. Not going to lie. Alright, I guess all my creatures are dead. So there is that. Get to play Master Waves. The Staticaster still can just clear out all the tokens, so I guess I just play the Master Waves. Alrighty. Staticaster is not a card every deck plays these days, but oh man, it is good in this matchup. Alright, let's play Master Waves. 2-1 Pro Red. Oh yeah. It does make my Mutavaults better. I mean, that's relevant. So I actually have a pretty good shot at just killing my opponent with Mutavault here, because next turn I get to animate both and still have Spell Pierce up. There's not much my opponent can play in a turn for value here. Deceiver Exarch? Oh, I'm playing against Grixis too, and I didn't even know that. Oh, I guess the Desolate Lighthouse kind of gives it away, but I don't know, I played Desolate Lighthouse and Grixis plenty of times. I'm glad my opponent played an Exarch there instead of when I attacked. I mean, granted, my opponent's hoping just to draw red mana and just to win the game, but still. Harbinger of the Tides is interesting. Could attack with my Mutavaults. They are 3/3s. What does that do for me? Not a lot, because if my opponent has another Exarch I guess second Staticaster is not that likely. Second Exarch is a little more likely. Draw. Ooh. The Great Glass Spinner. I like that. Well, not enough to cast it yet, though. I think I'd rather just keep up. I want to keep up Harbinger in case my opponent goes for the combo here. Alright. Another Exarch makes me glad I'm not attacking here. Because, yeah, my opponent could, like, double Staticaster my Mutavault after blocking both Mutavaults, then I just lose everything. Hopefully my opponent just goes for it here, because it makes sense to do that. I mean, I'm playing a Merfolk deck. I can't have that much disruption. But I'm going to Harbinger. Oh, Grimlaw of Mancer. That's not good for me. I was much happier when I thought my opponent was going for Splinter Twin here. Okay. Well, I guess I'll double block with my Mutavaults. I don't know what's going on here, but I mean, I'll take this. Granted, my opponent can now play another Exarch, but then it's just a trade. Lightning Bolt, Mutavault. Okay, I cannot prevent that. Alright. Mirror Regery. Interesting. So I think I play Mirror Regery uncounterably. And then play Harbinger of the Tides. With a spell pierce up. Bouncing Grim Lavamancer. Still can't attack though. But I can set it up so next turn I can start doing something. And now if my opponent slams Twin, I get to spell pierce it. I can't beat multiple Twins probably, but Grixis Twin usually only plays 3 Splinter Twins anyway. I mean, it could very easily look. And if my opponent doesn't go for it here, I have to assume they don't have it, because it seems like it's pretty appealing to go for it. And it's not like you're just dead if I don't have it. Alright, well, killing the Regery is not great for me. I'm going to take one. I don't know about these poking in for one here. I don't think it's getting my opponent a lot. Kira does not do much against Grim Lavamancer, unfortunately. Because Staticaster can poke away any shield. I can attack, but no, that doesn't even need to do anything. I am like super dead here. Because even if I draw Lord, yeah, I'm just going to die to this Grim Lavamancer. So my opponent having a lot more creatures in their deck is unfortunate. That makes me more inclined to want not the full amount of spell pierces, and actually definitely not relics. Yes, it's okay against Grim Lavamancer, but I'd much rather. I think Tidebinder to lock down Staticaster or Lavamancer is a little more interesting. And then Regery has more ways to get my Merfolk. Plus one, plus one is good. I want Vapor Snags and Dismember still. I should probably actually play all the Harbingers as well. So maybe I just take out the Curse Catchers because they're so bad against all the pinging effects. Alright, I would like to play first Aether Vial. No Aether Vial. How good is this hand? It is pretty medium. Yeah, I could do better than that, I think. Well, this hand's not good either. Problem with that last hand is I go like Mutavault go. Even if I draw blue, it doesn't really do anything for me. Well, I guess I gotta keep this. This hand probably can't win either, but I don't think I go to four. So what can you do? Alright, Mutavault. It's at least a card. So now I think my best play is to play Kira here. My opponent kept a Blood Crypt. That's a Lighthouse hand. Alright. I have to name Spirit so I can cast this, but that's alright. My opponent kept a hand with no blue mana but tons of removal. Kira is going to be great. Playing this on turn 2 is a pretty big sign that you do not have a lot of blue mana in your hand, or other lands at all. Well, I assume that was very lucky. Why does my opponent have to be the one to get lucky when I mulligan to 5? Because they clearly kept a hand without blue mana. Now they're going to cast like their Serum Visions or something? No. Let's cast Aether Vial. See how that goes. That resolves. Alright, let's just attack. Alright, Pestermite. Beginning of combat? Alright, I guess I dismember that now so I can attack with my Kira. I mean, it didn't matter because I have the Dismember, but it's kind of suspicious to not let me attack first. Wouldn't you want me to attack Kira into Pestermite? I guess they might have Splinter Twin in hand. Clearly no more lands, though. Again, my opponent kept a hand with just these two lands. There's no way they had Bloodstained Mire in their hand beforehand. All right, Staticaster. Very unfortunate for me. Let's play Marrow Reedgery and hope my opponent doesn't have a removal. Well, if I draw a bunch of Merfolk, or I draw a Dismember to kill that Staticaster, I don't feel too bad, but right now my opponent's gonna go like Staticaster, Bolt your Kira. Yeah. And that's just gonna be very bad for me. Hopefully they have Kolaghan's Command instead of Bolt. Because if they do that, then I can actually win this game. Yeah, they're deciding what modes to play on Kolaghan's Command right now. I like it. Because then I get to Spell Pierce that, and I do get to attack my opponent for like 7 damage. And if I draw a Merfolk to play this turn too, then we're really talking. Or they're in the tank about whether to bolt or Kolaghan's Command. I really hope it's Kolaghan's Command. It's so appealing, though. Like, you get to get a card or like an Aether Vial and a Kira. Like, how do you not cast that? Alright, get out of here. No, sir. Alright. Alright, let's put a counter on this. If I draw a Lord here, game. I mean, I guess not literal game, but this is very bad for my opponent. Yeah. Alright, we kind of did it. Kind of the perfect mulligan to 5. My opponent could now maybe Cryptic Command, or I guess Splinter Twin? I guess, no, they can't even cast Cryptic here. So, how do they get out of this? Alright, I'm going to leave Vial on 2. Let me see if I draw any spell that's insanely good for me. Alright, so let's animate Mutavault. And go to attacks. Splinter can Staticaster, it can bolt something. Snapcaster, bolt. The problem is they can Staticaster Kira, bolt Kira, Snapcaster, bolt Reedgery, or no, bolt Master. Block Reedgery and still die. They have to chump then with Staticaster, but they have to kill the Master before. I guess they can leave the Master unblocked and then chump Mutavault. No, they have to kill the Master in order to block Mutavault. So I think even if my opponent has Lightning Bolt plus Snapcaster Mage, I think I'm in okay shape here. Is that accurate? Play Snapcaster, assign blocker on Mutavault. Assign block, and yeah, you have to use it. You have to kill Master before blocks. You can Staticaster bolt Master, but then you have to do it to Kira. So you have to do it before blocks. You Staticaster Kira, bolt Kira, Snapcaster Mage. bolt master block one of my 3/3s die. All right, I think this works, but I mean, I guess I'll let my opponent run through the math themselves. Also, what if my opponent has like a Pestermite or something? Static Aster gets countered, play Pestermite, untap Static Aster, bolt master. All right, I mean, I guess I can't do anything anyway, so I'll let my opponent do all these things. All right, so Kira is bolted. Here's the Snapcaster. Yeah, and you're at 3. I think you still die. You bolt the Master now. Oh, no, you chump the Mutavault and you go to 1. Right, okay, so you don't die, but you don't get good value. Alright, well, the game's definitely not over, though, because opponent on 1 is not an opponent on 0, especially against a handful. So, I might be back to needing to draw something here. And opponent did have to have Bolt Staticaster, or Bolt Snapcaster, but they kept a hand without land, so clearly they're going to have good cards in it. Yeah, so actually I might be losing here still. I need to draw. Vapor Snag would, I assume, be my best draw. Though, drawing random Merfolk would be pretty good too. Mutavault. So is there a reason to attack with Mutavault? I guess there's no reason not to attack with Mutavault. If my opponent has a way to kill Rejuri, then at the very worst I'm trading with Pestermite or getting blocked by Deceiver Exarch. I don't think there's a reason to attack with Rejuri here. I mean, I guess my concern with attacking with Rejuri is if my opponent plays Deceiver, they can just double ping the Rejuri anyway. I assume Rejuri's dying here. I mean, there's no way that's not the case, right? Alright, Pestermite, yeah. Actually, I'm gonna lose this game. Brutal. Sadly, I don't have another Lord to Violin, though my opponent could even still have a Bolt. Alright. And if my opponent has a Splinter Twin, then I do end up losing here. Why is it that my opponent gets lucky? I mean, I got very lucky too, but I wanted to get luckier than my opponent. The idea is not to have my opponent get luckier than me. That's not why you play Magic. Let's see see if my opponent has the Twin. Of course they do. All right, well, Merfolk did pretty well. Harbinger seemed like a real card, so I was not unhappy with how that all went.